Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, we have seen the implementation of the adapter class and the SQLite open helper class. We have not yet implemented insert, delete, query, and update methods, which we shall see in this particular video. Before I continue with the actual implementation, I want you guys to be familiar with two important APIs, that is Cursor and ContentValues. Cursor is basically used to iterate through the rows that are there in the table, and the ContentValue is nothing but a key value pair representing the column and the value that you want to add to that particular column in the table. If you are not familiar with these two APIs, I suggest that you go through the content provider playlist in which I have explained the usage of these two APIs in a very detailed manner. So let's get started with the very first operation, which is insert operation. The method basically takes three arguments. The first one is the table name. The second one is string type, which is a null column hack. And the third argument is the content values, which is basically the column and value pair that you want to insert into that particular table. The return type is a long, which represents ID of the tuple that got inserted into the table. If it is -1, that means something went wrong, the insertion failed. Internally, this method is equivalent to a insert into table SQLite statement. Delete method takes once again three arguments. The first one is the table name. The second and third arguments are basically the where clauses to do the delete operation in the table. And the return type is integer, representing how many rows got deleted after you executed this particular statement. From the looks of it, you can make out that it looks like a delete from table SQLite statement. The query method basically takes table and the columns that you want to select, then the selection clause itself. If you have multiple selection clauses, you can pass them as string array, and then you can group by having order by conditions. And the last argument is limit, which basically tells how many number of tuples you want the statement to return. And the return type is a cursor. You can basically iterate through the cursor to actually read the values returned by the query. This is actually equivalent to a select statement that you typically write using your SQL statement. Then comes update method. So once again, you need to pass the table where you want to do the updation, the content values, which contains the new key value pair containing the column and the value that you want to associate with that particular column, and then where clause, which is passed as string where clause and where arguments. The return type is an integer, basically telling how many rows got affected when you executed this particular statement, and it is equivalent to a update table SQL statement that you typically execute in SQL. It is now time to see all these statements in action through a demo. So we will continue to add on the extra functionality in the same application that I had created in the previous video. The remaining implementation is basically to implement insert, delete, modify, and query methods. To do the insertion, you basically have to create a key value pair of content values, and in the content values, you have to put key, which is column to do, and the value is to do item that is being passed as the argument. And then SQLite database, insert, table, to do, null column hack value is always passed as null, and then the third parameter is content values, and this will return me a ID, and if this ID is greater than 0, that means a successful insertion happened. So I just want to return a boolean value indicating whether a successful insertion happened or not. So I can just write return and check whether it is greater than 0. And to do the delete operation, what I can do is SQLite database dot delete from the table, so you need to give the name of the table, and then where clause, and the where clause is column ID should be equal to whatever the ID that I am passing here. And the third parameter in this case, as of now, I want to keep it null because I don't have any multiple selections, so you can give it null here. Check whether it is greater than 0, and if it is greater than 0, that means a successful deletion has happened. Now coming to the update operation, what I can do is create a key value pair containing the new value that I want to update. So let me create a content values. This content value will have column name and the new value, and then SQLite database dot update name of the table. Then you have to pass the content values, and then the where clause. Where clause is once again I can utilize this itself, and finally null argument because I don't have any multiple selections. If this is greater than 0, that means a successful updation has happened. And then comes finally query method. Create a list of to-dos. To do is a bean class which contains ID and the string value. Initially, the size of this particular list would be 0. Now, cursor is equal to SQLite database dot query. You can see that there are various overloaded methods. The one that I would be using is this one, table name, and then columns that you want to query. If you just pass null here, basically all the columns will be selected. It is like writing select star. I just want to explicitly write the column names here. So it would be column ID and column to do. And then if you have many other selections, you can give here. As of now, I am not doing any other selection because I just want all the values that are there in my database. So this returns me a cursor. Check if the cursor is not equal to null and cursor.count is greater than 0. That means you have some values being returned in the cursor. Then only you proceed to parse the cursor. You can use a while loop. Cursor has got a method called as move next, which basically moves the cursor to the next item in the row if it exists in the cursor. Then create a to-do item, and if you observe the to-do item constructor, I have a parameterized constructor also. I can use the parameterized constructor to create the to-do item here. So cursor.getLong0, that will basically give me the ID, and then cursor.getString, that will give me the to-do item. Make sure that the indexing is proper, otherwise you will get exception, and then add it to the list. And after that is done, you can just return the to-do list. We are done with the implementation of all the four methods. Now the question is, how can I utilize this in my application? For that, you need to wire up the code in the presentation layer of the application, which is main activity. We shall see that in the next video. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.